Okay, Billy, let's see what you can do. Take this. This is the hammer. You know what to do. I taught you well. I believe you can do this.
All right. Let me shut myself.
That's right, Billy.
Oh, my eye! Oh!
Are you okay?
Billy, that was horrendous, okay? You are really bad.
It was just a practice try.
Look at this.
Whoa! That is the worst practice try I've ever seen. Stop. Billy, what is your favorite subject?
Physics!
Good, because I'm going to teach you how to become better at this sport using the concepts of circular motion. Okay, so let me draw you a diagram. Here's a circle with you in the middle. Now, do you remember the laws of circular motion from class?
Yeah, from Miss Batista!
The key concepts of circular motion are an object moving in a circle at a constant speed accelerates towards the center of the circle and therefore has centripetal acceleration. The velocity vector of an object with a centripetal acceleration is always tangent to the circular path. Centripetal acceleration depends directly on the square of the object's speed and inversely on the radius of the circle. This can be seen in the equation A sub C equals V squared over R. Centripetal acceleration can also be expressed as a function of its period t as seen in the equation A sub C equals 4 pi squared r over t squared, and a net force must be exerted towards the center, circle center, to cause centripetal acceleration as seen in this equation F sub C is equal to MA sub C.
Very good, Billy. Now, the most important part of these concepts is that the velocity vector of an object with a centripetal acceleration is always tangent to the circular path. When you let go of the hammer, it will go off in a tangent to the circle you created by spinning it.
I don't get it.
Idiot. By increasing the force you exert on the hammer, you will also increase the centripetal acceleration. Because centripetal acceleration is directly related to velocity, the greater the velocity you can produce, the farther you will throw the hammer.
But don't you also have to deal with angles and...
That doesn't concern me. Pretend like you never learned that.
All right!
Good. Now let's work on increasing that velocity.
That don't kill me, can only make me stronger. I need you to hurry up, man, cause I can't wait much longer. I know I got to be right, man, cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night, man, that's how long I've been on ya. Let's get lost tonight. You could be my black Kate Moss tonight. Play secretary on the ball tonight.
Didn't I already tell you? This is not hammer throwing equipment. Take the glasses off.
Alright, today is the day of the competition. I've got my wonderful tracksuit ready. Helga ready to yell at me and my family supporting me.
We're here on Physics BS News following the story of a young boy named Billy. He was on the main program of MTV and now he is using physics to become a hammer thrower. And here we have one of Billy's relatives visiting us to see him do his hammer throwing. And his parents will, we don't know where they are. Well, all I can say is that he better do good, because my mom promised me
By using my extremely high-tech gadgets, I have figured out that the current high scorer used a force of 75 newtons. Since an average men's hammer weighs 16 pounds, or roughly 7.257 kilograms, his centripetal acceleration was about 10 meters per second squared. That means that since the radius of this circle used is 121.5 centimeters, or 1.215 meters, by using the formula A sub c equals v squared over r, I can determine his velocity was roughly 3.5 meters a second. You must exert more force than that, or else it is all over.
No problem, Helga. I've been working out.
Pause. Billy, it is time. Your whole life up until this moment has been in preparation of this contest. Remember, it's hammer time! Now go!
Hundred.